How's it going, guys? How y'all doing?
Great. How are you?
Doing wonderful. How you doing?
Good. Doing good.
This is Mr. Harry Brown, is it not?
Yeah, it's Harry Brown. He works down at the garbage with me sometimes. He doesn't really do it full-time much anymore, but, you know, he helps when he can.
Tell me, Mr. Lang, before we get started, do you have a sanitation union operating down there?
Yeah.
Do you run that union?
Yes, sir.
Do you run it alone or with others?
Got a couple of guys that help.
Would you call these couple of guys a council?
What do you mean by council?
Well, I got a strange call last night. Someone calls me off the yellow pages, asked to meet. Real pressed about me being in the union. Said that he's one of the council on the tow and sanitation union.
Oh, not this fucking shit again.
Real territorial, talking about authority and this and that. I was just wondering if that was one of your boys.
No. So what seems to be happening right now, we actually got this information this fucking morning. There's a crew going around claiming to be the tow and sanitation union, and Harry Brown here actually works at tow, and we're thinking that these guys are trying to, but to be frank, these motherfuckers, you know, saw that unions are getting started up. I think they're trying to, you know, cash in on whatever fad they think it is, and they're trying to, strong arm their way in. It's very strange, I'm gonna be honest.
$20 a day, that's what they were asking.
Yeah, we heard they got fees. They require you to give them all your fucking blueprints, whatever the fuck that means. And they'll offer you protection. It don't fucking sound like a unit. I'm going to be straight up. It sounds like a bunch of fucking gangbangers trying to fucking make a quick buck.
Okay. A bunch of highway robbers, is that what it is?
Yeah.
They also put stickers up with their names at the sanitation yard. I don't know if you've seen that.
Well, I did get into one of these guys this morning because they kept fucking taking down our flyers trying to put theirs up. And when I spoke with these guys, what they were saying was making absolutely no sense to me, because we got guys in the in the fucking later hours working who never heard of this union, but these guys are trying to claim that they've been around for a long time. So it's very strange. I'm not really sure what their motive is.
Well, they came out stronger and started backpedaling near the end of the conversation. So everything's okay. I just wanted to verify if this man was with you. His name was Sean. Does that ring a bell?
Is it Shano or some shit?
Sean Blackwood, another guy named Carl Johnny.
That don't ring any bells to me. Does it ring any bells to you, Harry?
Nah, not all guys.
Conor McGregor.
That name rings a bell, but for different fucking reasons.
That's right. Well, you see, we're union men up here, and we like to do things by the book the right way, so we don't jeopardize anybody's profession.
Yeah?
So we have no qualms with going through a union to make sure we're operating the right way. The only problem is these guys, like you said, they didn't feel like a union.
Just to clarify, we ain't got nothing to do with these fucking people. I mean, like I told you, my hunch is they're a bunch of fucking gangbangers trying to make a quick buck, is what it sounds like. They're trying to strong-arm their way in. They're feeding you some sort of bullshit story by claiming they're fucking established, when in reality doesn't seem that way. Listen, all right? Sanitation is a very hard job. I don't know if you guys have done it, but most people who tend to do it want to fucking jump off of a fucking, you know, rooftop after doing it for 5 minutes. What we're doing is we're picking out the people who are committed and they can fucking, you know, endure that. And bring them onto the fucking union. Now, I think people are fucking catching wind of how, much of a shithole it is down there. And they're trying just to get a bunch of people to fucking run materials for them. And you know, that's not what we're in the business of doing. So I think they're trying to, you know, rival us in some fucking way. I think they're doing a fucking terrible job at it. And, I just wouldn't fucking listen to a single word that comes out of their mouths, I'm going to be honest.
Now, they were talking about a protection racket. You experienced roving bands of Muppets with wrenches knocking you over the head and stealing what you got in your truck?
I heard one guy that got robbed. for his materials, but you know, people under have been working for, you know, under our unit, you know, we've been fine. We go out in groups, you know, everyone's got a wrench, and you know, we have kind of a process that we do to make sure we're safe.
Okay.
Now, it ain't gonna surprise me if these things kind of tend to become more common as the days go by. You know, these robberies and shit.
Sure. So, now to the matter at hand. We had a discussion yesterday over the telephone.
Yeah?
About collecting the materials with all hands on deck, funneling them to you at $2 per as advertised in exchange for certain guarantees.
Right.
The guarantees being full and open support and guaranteed votes for Stelio, the guy
That's
who's
right.
representing the labor unions, people like us. Now, is that something that you're still willing to commit on?
Yeah, I mean, I fucking told you over the phone. I'm a man of my fucking word. I mean, you want the votes, we can guarantee you the votes. I mean, we can guarantee you more than just sanitation as well. I mean, we got one of our, you know, one of our guys who's got a, you know, a good hold over at Senior Buns. He kind of runs the joint in the morning. A lot of people, you know, look up to him. He can guarantee the votes as well. I spoke to him this morning before we met.
Lane, would they be willing to openly support him?
Yeah, I mean, why not?
Okay. It's really important that this Stelio guy gets into office, because otherwise, us labor people, we're fucked. We got no representation in office. We're out here starving, barely making any money. Our lumber camp is busted and nobody seems to care. I can't for the life of me figure out how a guy can spend 24 hours a day breaking his back, cutting lumber, digging out trash, and still can't fucking afford to feed himself. Meanwhile, some up is flipping burgers for 3 shifts and is making thousands and thousands of dollars.
Yeah, it's a fucking shit show if you ask me. I mean, I tend to agree. That's why I took a phone call.
Beautiful. So, you said something on the phone about not selling to anybody else these meds. What did you mean by that?
Well, you have... All right, so to kind of explain this best way that I can, you have motherfuckers who, you know, are moving at a fucking 1,000 miles an hour right now, and they're trying to, they predict that their prediction is that the fucking material and, you know, the lumber market is going to skyrocket eventually. So what they're fucking trying to do right now is get in early and scam motherfuckers. I mean, it's the reason why we started this, you know, the unit down at sanitation, because we had guys coming around trying to buy materials at 30 cents a pop. 30 fucking cents. So imagine a guy picking up garbage for about a fucking 8-hour shift, getting paid, you know, $200-$300 for the materials he's got.
That don't sound real nice.
Yeah, straight up fucking scam. These people coming in, you know, trying to sell, you know, a promise. They're going to fucking make you money. You know, we're going to work together, whatever. You know, we thought it was fucking bullshit. We knew exactly what they were fucking doing. So we stepped in. We told motherfuckers, sell us your materials. We'll pay you a fair price of $2 a material. And, you know, you don't have to, you know, get yourself scammed by these pieces of shit. Couple of days go by. I don't know if you fucking noticed, but the market is pretty much at $2 now. So everybody at sanitation that's actually putting the fucking time into work is getting, you know, what I believe is a fair value for what they're doing.
You know, Mr. Lang, I'm more interested in us unions being on good terms. Today, you know, while the lumber camp is busted, we'll put all hands on deck. We'll collect these materials.
Bill busted!
And pass them to for the right price, of course. The people that we think our interests are aligned with. I think we have a common ground, like you mentioned over the phone yesterday. But, you know, maybe tomorrow it's not Matt's that we're focusing on. Maybe we go all in on lumber once this place is operational again. But I'd like to maintain that relation between the unions. That fee is way more important. What do you say to that?
I mean, it's like I said, right? I think if, you know, if the real sanitation union, which is what we run, but the people are, and I guarantee you more people are going to come up here to try to convince you otherwise. And you can believe what you want at the fucking end of the day. But if we can make, you know, a formal alliance, so to speak, you know, for lack of a better term, between the sanitation and the lumber, we can, you know, help control fucking both markets and make sure both of our fucking people down there are, you know, and up here are fucking getting what they're fucking deserve. You can see for your fucking self, you already have people coming out of the fucking shadows pretending to be this, that, and the third to try to take advantage of people. Fucking demanding fucking daily fees and shit for whatever protection that they fucking offer when they're probably the same guys fucking robbing you.
Okay, now this I really like. Now I think we're hitting on something very special. An alliance, like you mentioned, call it what you will, is something that I think will favor the both of us. In the time being, while we go down there and do some sanitation ourselves, I want my people to be operating within your union specifically for the time being, until the machinery is up here and working properly. If anybody asks, talks, for all intents and purposes, you and yours are the official sanitation union, and everybody else is a fraud and a scam. We ask that the sanitation union operate in the same way in regards to the lumber camp up here and the lumber union, which would be through us, the only official lumber union.
Yeah, I mean, anyone that's asked, you know, I made sure to, you know, make them understand that this fucking Kettleman guy is the one, you know, running the union up there, whoever his people are.
Now, that would allow us to have our fingers on the pulse of all the materials, from plastic all the way to timber. And I think that would be extremely advantageous to us.
Now, I agree.
To be honest with you, our time in the city is very fresh, and I've asked around a whole bunch, or maybe a little, and it turns out you guys have a lot of history here. You have more understanding on how the city operates and politics and economy, etc., etc. So, as we go forward, I think it would be good occasionally to be able to sit down and in some type of conference or meeting with the representatives of these unions to discuss, plan, and understand how to go forward, because that is something that we will need, that insight and that experience going forward.
I mean, yeah, listen, I think this can work out very fucking well. I think, you know, obviously we don't know each other, you know, very well. You know, me and Harry, we do have a lot of fucking history here, but, you know, we've been out of the city for a while, you know, personal reasons that and that. You know, we're back. We ain't want problems with nobody. We ain't trying to hold anybody, you know, accountable to some shit that happened in the past. You know, what's in the past is in the past for us. And, you know, we're really trying to come back and, you know, make a name for our fucking selves. And, you know, just make an honest living for the most of it. Taking advantage of.
I cannot stress how important this mayoral candidacy is. If we could have a labor representative in the mayoral position, he could be able to legitimize the official unions and therefore deeming everybody else a scam. So that is absolutely paramount for us. I would like this Stelio guy to meet your union representatives and for, again, like you said, to officially be in this game for him. And if that is agreed upon, which I think it is, then I think we have a deal.
Yeah, I mean, we can guarantee you that, you know, no problem. I mean, at the end of the fucking day, people are going to vote for who they want to vote for. But we got people that we can guarantee votes 100%. My question to you would be, who is this person's competitor? So, you know, how many people are running in total and shit?
There's a guy, Vivek, okay? He's running around jump scaring people from behind bushes, doing the gritty, telling people to vote for him. He's real popular, but a video came out yesterday of him being witness to a murder. So I think his chance of getting mayor is out the window.
Jesus. That's right. Christ.
That's right. It was all over the news yesterday.
He's a psychopath.
Then you have a guy named Max. Now, this is the big competitor. This Max guy apparently was a big somebody back in the day, and he's got a lot of old-timers, old money backing him. But I tell you what, Max ain't never come down for 1 second over here to the lumber union. I don't think he spent 1 minute in sanitation trying to figure out what the fuck we need. Just saying. This Max guy is not gonna care for 1 second about our future, our well-being. So I don't think it makes any fucking sense to back this guy. He's already in somebody's pocket. His interests are elsewhere. Now, Stelio has the entire backing of the lumber union.
Yeah.
He's got the entire backing of Mosley's. Or had. After this conversation, I think that's going to take a turn. If you went...
Sorry, go ahead.
Go ahead. No, you go ahead. Well, I was going to say with Mosley's, with them and some other people that I won't mention, some big groups, they have secretly told us that they are more than willing to back him. If you and yours, your connections, everybody at Senor Bonds openly backs Stelio, I think he has a legitimate chance of winning.
What the fuck is Stelio? I've never met this guy.
A legitimate chance of winning. He's been parading the law-abiding approach to gather the police and EMS vote. And that's something that I don't think this Max guy is doing. I really think that Stelio has a legitimate chance of winning. And that will be key to the future of the unions.
Okay. Now, I don't want to be that fucking guy, right?
Be that guy.
I'm going to be that guy. I've never heard of a man named Stelio. So if he's campaigning, he might be doing a terrible job at it. I don't think I've even seen like a fucking ads, you know, posters everywhere, motherfuckers running around campaigning for him. And this guy got a campaign team or what?
Well, that's because he's actually going from fucking person to person. He's not twatting all fucking day.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
So that's his tactic? It's kind of just direct to the person?
Well, the tactic is exactly what we're doing now.
Gotcha.
I'd like to secure a face-to-face with him and your reps.
Okay. I mean, listen, we guarantee our fucking votes 100%. What I want to know is, right, if this man loses, I don't want this fucking relationship to be contingent on that. Because then it just kind of seems like a fucking waste of time. I think no matter what, through thick and thin, we fucking work together.
I was going to say the same thing. I think I wouldn't bank on this guy winning as much as you are. You need to have a plan B for sure.
Okay, I wholeheartedly agree. Wholeheartedly. But I do think we need to make a strong push.
Yeah, I mean, listen, we're going to fucking push, and I can guarantee you that. I got a lot of people who are good at that, and, you know, our associate that work at fucking Senior Buns, it's almost like a dictator over there. I tell you right now, motherfuckers work a shift. They get, like, fucking 15 work receipts. They give this guy 5, every single employee there. It's like clockwork, all right? We can guarantee votes, no fucking problem. I'd recommend, though, this guy does more of a public push. I mean, fucking twatter and flyers and shit is annoying as fuck, but it really does help get the name in people's minds, you know?
Okay, now, for the materials, just for the time being, I told you yesterday that people are making a strong petition to us. I mean, they're going as far as busting out the knee pads, getting down and begging. But if we make a deal to be exclusive, we'll honor that deal. However, say we collect 1,000 pieces of PVC pipe. You could only buy 200 at the moment. We can't just let that 800 sit in a storage somewhere. We will give you first rights, exclusivity that way. And whatever you can't buy, that we will pawn off elsewhere. Does that sound right to you?
I mean, I'm going to be honest. We'll probably buy everything you have all the time.
Everything.
Have you guys worked sanitation yet?
Yeah, I did a long shift yesterday.
Oh, all right. You know what I mean? It just ain't the, you know, it ain't the most, it's some fucking brain dead shit, to put it lightly. So, you know, it's if you're trying to get a fuck ton of materials, it's going to require a lot of fucking work down there. But, you know, Well, mostly of what you have, we'll probably buy all at once. You know, all the fucking time, no problem.
So we bring you 2,000 materials, you're going to buy all 2,000.
Yeah, if you have 2,000 materials right now, we buy them all right now.
Our guy is asleep at the moment with the materials. He works the night shift. He's the one holding it all for us.
Well, that brings me to my next question. How many of people work the late night shifts right now? Because the problem is, I feel like fugazi-ass fucking unions that these motherfuckers are trying to claim they run are happening in the fucking later hours. And I don't got much manpower there to help keep things controlled.
When you say control, what do you have in
Jack,
mind?
Jack, I mean, just
go ahead.
Usually, in the later hours, that's when I'm usually awake. So I can definitely, go down there and keep an eye out and pick up some notes here and there.
Yeah, I mean, information is key, right? We just got to know what these guys are trying to do. What I mean by controlled is I just don't want motherfuckers coming down there and trying to just take advantage of a market. Their mindset, I'm telling you, straight up, is to come and take advantage. As I'm sure they've come up to you and fucking offer you maybe 10% of what your fucking lumber is worth. Try to sell you on some bullshit as to why you should sell it. These people are going to keep fucking coming until they realize they cannot break through, the barrier that was built.
Listen, so that's why I'm asking, what is your union called? So that whenever me and mine go, we operate through your union, the only official union as far as sanitation goes. That's very important, I think, especially if we work the later shifts. Because when I went yesterday, everybody and their mother was there. I was seeing MCs over there. I was seeing stoners over there. I was seeing everybody. Plots going left and right about sanitation. I got business owners coming to me talking about mats. Everybody is reaching out for mats. And some of them are in a panic talking to me about your twats. So it's very important if we do it, that my guys do it through a union. And I want them to do it through your union.
Guys, give me a name quick. So that's something I want to understand as well, right? So if you're around in the late hours, what is the want of people to work sanitation? Is there really a fuck ton of people that desperate to work sanitation in the late hours?
You must have caused a stir, because it seems to me that everybody is funneling over there. When we did our first shift, there were so many people on duty that we didn't even have any trash to collect.
That's true.
Fuck. And
we had to clock off and do it, several hours later. Just to be able to even pick up any garbage.
Okay, and how many of these people would you say... So, the way I look at it, right? There's people that work their fucking jobs, and then there's people who are hopping on what they think is a quick cash grab. For example, in my mind, you work lumber, right? But the guy next to you, as an example, he might just be here for a fucking day... So he gets fucking bored, and the next thing you know, he's working down at Moses fixing cars. You know what I mean? For us, we just care to focus on the people who truly work down there and are looking to really make a living down there. I don't give a shit if there's fucking 500 people down there fucking working, one night, because the reality is, in 3-4 days, there's going to be two.
Okay, I hope you're right about this. Listen, since we're going to be working officially, I'm going to go ahead and tell you. So, Dundee, the guy running Mosley's with Mary Mushkin, they are wanting to push heavy, heavy for mats. Now, they want me to mobilize my workers over here to push for mats. But the deal
proving my point right now. Sorry to interrupt you. This guy, came up here, fucking said, I want your fucking people to run the fucking materials for me. I make the big... The big bad king at the fucking end of the table while my fucking peasants come and give me materials. Is that it?
Well, he had more of an accent when he was talking.
Oh, fuck it. This fucking Dundee guy, I've heard his name already 5 times today, and he just sounds like fucking problems. I want nothing to do with the guy. Apparently, he's fucking going down to some sort of mechanic shop and, blowing shit up over there. Got one of the guys arrested or some shit. I ain't looking to fucking make enemies unless I absolutely have to. I ain't looking to fucking knock down fucking doors and claim I'm the fucking big bad wolf like what this guy seemingly seems to fucking be doing, if I'm being honest.
So what do you foresee if everybody is sending, you know, all of their family members, friends, neighbors, begging them to go collect materials? How do you foresee this going forward if people just keep funneling and funneling and funneling?
Well, I think one is understanding how real that is, right? Because I could go beg 50 people to collect materials for me, and I'm telling you, my man, they might do it for a fucking hour. And then they might never do it again. And then the guys that might stick to it for a couple of days are really going to realize that it ain't worth what these other people are trying to pay them. Because these people are only doing it to get the cheapest fucking deal. They ain't doing it for the fucking market value. Otherwise, they wouldn't be begging people.
Okay. So, the plan was to sell to you first, to funnel the materials to your organization, and whatever you couldn't purchase off the top, we were going to pass it over to the other buyers. For example, Mr. Dundee, who, by the way, has been real good to us.
And just to clarify,
to union.
Sorry to interrupt again, just to clarify, you're speaking materials or you're speaking lumber?
Materials.
Okay. Yeah, all right.
That's right.
He just tweeted at you.
Who tweeted at me?
Crazy timing.
Dundee.
Jesus Christ. I might have been him that called him, to be honest.
Now,
sorry, go ahead.
So, Mr. Lang, Dundee and Mosley's has been really good to the Lumberjacks. They were giving us deals on repairing our cars. They had decided to back Stelio up until now. And so we come to the point of the material business. And we have two suitors right now. There's you and there's him. Now, what you're saying here, I think, is a lot more long-term and beneficial to us. And your offers make a lot more sense to our union.
Yeah, like I said, I think you know, I'm a big picture kind of guy. I don't think of the short term, and you know, maybe I'm wrong, and I could be. I'm not a prophet, but I feel like a lot of people wrapped up in this shit right now are thinking very short term. Until the fucking next hype comes around, they're gonna hop on that.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and tell him, which is probably gonna cost us all of the Mosley vote, which he was pushing for, that our materials are going to you and he can purchase them from you. But whatever you don't buy, what you can't afford, we're going to pass off to other people just so they're not sitting there, okay?
Yeah, I mean, that's fine with me. I tell you right now, though, I don't think there is a number you can produce, and I'm not trying to be disrespectful here, that we couldn't buy all at once. I'm just being honest.
Okay. Now, with that said, I still need to know what your union is called or how to go about telling people that we are working strictly to your official union.
Well, right now we're just calling ourselves the Los Santos Waste Management Union, but we're trying to think of rebranding it now because of these motherfuckers coming out of the shadows pretending to be some shit else. We really want some of that pops and sticks to people's heads. So, you know, we're kind of just working internally on that right now.
Okay, that is very, very important. So when we tell people, we will tell them that, we'll attach the title official to it. And I will tell them to contact representatives Lang Buddha and Harry Brown if they have any questions.
Yeah, you can throw in, I don't know his first name, but his name's Cunningham. We call him Cy. Maybe his first name is Cy. I think it's a nickname.
How the fuck do you not know your own rep's name?
We call him Cy, but I don't know if that's a fucking nickname or not.
Cy, Harry Lang Buddha, okay.
Yeah, and then Dougie.
And Dougie.
Kind of like the main forces of the union right now.
All right, beautiful. Done deal.
Are any of your numbers in the yellow pages? Because when I'm around later, I can just send you a heads up if I see or hear anything.
Yeah, my number is should be in there right now, I think. Let me double check. Oh, no, I took a nap, actually. Let me put the yellow page back up. One second.
Okay. Like by the name of a disco, by the way.
And in the meantime, of course, if anybody needs lumber or anything like that, you tell them to come to the official lumber union, the one and only.
Yeah, of course. I mean, what's the situation on lumber right now? You guys stocking up on that shit? You trying to push that shit already? What's your plan for that, if you mind me asking?
Brother, some people put some lumber in sideways, and our machinery here is busted, and we got some back orders. So we're going to put in another shift, see if all of that is sorted out, because we're getting orders already for timber.
Okay. And, I don't know how to ask this, but you guys planning on being up here long term? You know what I mean? Can we rely on you on you guys to be up here all the fucking time or what?
We're putting our roots deep into Polito for the long term.
Damn.
We're planning on living up here. We're planning on owning properties up here. We're planning on making sure this whole place runs smoothly, effectively, and beautifully.
All right, that's what I like to fucking hear. Fuck yeah. All right, I hope you, wish you the best luck on that.
But this time, we're also going to go to the city and fucking enjoy ourselves and do some sanitation once in a while.
Yeah, I mean, hey, sanitation's open to anybody that wants to fucking do it. You know what I mean? We're not going to, gatekeep anybody.
Okay, beautiful. So, we'll have your reps meet with Stelio within the next few days, tonight, maybe tomorrow. Whenever.
Yeah, I would love to meet the guy. Preferably tonight would be great, honestly. I need to get a sense of the guy before. I'm going to push for him, but it would be good to know who the fucking guy is too,
100%. We'll have him come down to the city and meet you.
All right.
And meet you and yours. Mr. Harry, what are your thoughts on all that's being discussed, if you don't mind me asking?
I think you guys need to prepare, look what's happened just kind of overnight with materials down at sanitation. Probably the same thing's going to happen to you guys eventually. So I'd make sure everything's in order. Start thinking about maybe a little bit too soon, but just know, the same's probably going to happen to lumber. It might not look too good right now, but it's going to come, and you're going to face the same thing that we're dealing with. People are trying to buy in super cheap, and they're trying to make sure that the people who are working are getting paid pennies while they make all the profits, so...
And on top of that, motherfuckers are—they're really gonna come up here and try to strong arm you out of your position. If I'm being honest, there are gonna be people that are fucking be crazy enough to do that. I mean,
I would like to see them try. There's a lot of angsty lumberjacks up here. I would like to see them try.
That's what I like to fucking hear. You guys gotta make sure. It's just a word of advice. We've been around for a while. Just be prepared. Don't fucking trust too easily. Kind of ironic to say that, but you never know what motherfuckers really want.
Okay, now, last order of business, what is your relationship like with Dundee?
I don't know the guy.
I mean, I don't really know the guy. The thing is, I'm going off of what I've heard about the guy, and I did have an altercation with him this morning because he tore down one of our fucking union flyers, threw up his own flyer up there, and said, come to Mosley's, we're buying all materials, $2 a pop. Then I fucking reamed them out. Told him, listen, asshole, instead of coming down to our yard where you don't fucking work, why don't you contact us and maybe we can fucking work a deal on, getting you guys supplied or whatever, right? He seemed to calm down a bit, and we were going to fucking chat. But then I had a fucking business meeting with somebody else. I don't really want to expose who they are, but I feel like I have to, so just keep this between us. I'm Mary Mushkin, and she also runs things down at Mosley's, and she runs it very well, in my opinion. And she straight up told me just to stay away from Dundee.
That is very curious that she told you that, because they're working together.
But Mary Mushkin is now dealing with the same shit that we're fucking dealing in sanitation. Motherfuckers are trying to come around and claim they own the joint. Dundee's trying to do the same shit. But then I'm hearing today, we were supposed to go down and have a meeting with another mechanic shop regarding, a potential, transaction of materials or whatever, right? We go down there, we hear the fucking owner of the shop is in a fucking bench trial for fucking assaulting Dundee, and then we look into why he assaulted Dundee, and apparently fucking Dundee was like fucking launching trucks and shit into his mechanic shop trying to blow it up.
Interesting.
Yeah, so I personally, you guys do what you want to do at the end of the day. I don't want to deal with a motherfucker who's trying to make enemies of everybody when what I believe the most important thing right now is solid relationships, business, right? Business relationships. I think it's very important. I don't want to close the door on anybody. Doesn't mean I'm going to trust everybody and work with everybody. But you don't want to pass up on opportunities. And I ain't going to work with a guy who's seems to be closing a lot of doors for himself right now.
So I'll leave you with this. I'm going to contact him and tell him that all the materials that are gathered through sanitation, he will have to get through the Sanitation Union reps, which will be you guys. And the Lover Union and the Sanitation Union, you know, are working together naturally, the two official unions. And I would ask that if you can to keep things amicable with him, because again, Mosley's has been great to us. And maybe that's a contact and support that we don't want to burn. But if it happens, you know, so be it.
Yeah.
Okay. If anybody asks, we're going to be telling them that all materials go through the Sanitation Union, the official Sanitation Union.
Yeah. Listen, if you guys fucking need materials, we can supply as well if you ever find yourselves needing it. And, you know, maybe, in the future, it's kind of hard to predict, but I feel like we're going to, you know, be needing a lot of lumber as well.
For sure. All right, partner, is there anything else that you want to go over?
If you're talking to us, I mean, I think we're good, honestly, unless Harry's got any questions.
No questions. I will just say this, definitely get your guys reaching out to Cy and Lang as like first kind of points of contact, all right, with the union stuff.
You got Cy's number?